Good morning, it's good to be back. Our reading this morning is from the letter to the Philippians, and it's mainly chapter 3 with a sniff at the end of the beginning of chapter 4. Finally, my brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord. To write the same things to you is not troublesome to me, and for you it is a safeguard. Beware of the dogs. Beware of the evil workers. Beware of those who mutilate the flesh. For it is we who are the circumcision, who worship in the Spirit of God, and boast in Christ Jesus, and have no confidence in the flesh. Even though I too have reason for confidence in the flesh. If anyone else has reason to be confident in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day, a member of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew, born of Hebrews, as to the law, a Pharisee, as to zeal, a persecutor of the church, as to righteousness under the law, blameless. Yet, whatever gains I had, these I have come to regard as loss. Because of Christ. More than that, I regard everything as lost because of the surpassing value of knowing Jesus Christ my Lord. For his sake I have suffered the loss of all things. I regard them as rubbish, in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him. Not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, one that comes through faith in Christ. The righteousness from God based on faith. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the sharing of his sufferings by becoming like him in his death, if somehow I may attain the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already obtained this or have already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own. But this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on towards the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus. Let those of us then who are mature be of the same mind, and if you think differently about anything, this too God will reveal to you. Only let us hold fast to what we have attained. Brothers and sisters, join in imitating me. And observe those who live according to the example you have in us. For many live as enemies of the cross of Christ. I have often told you of them, and now I tell you even with tears, their end is destruction. Their God is the belly, their glory is in their shame, their minds are set on earthly things, but our citizenship is in heaven, and it is from there that we are expecting a Saviour, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will transform the body of our humiliation so that it may be conformed to the body of his glory, by the power that also enables him to make all things subject to himself. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, my beloved. We thank God for his word to us in that piece of scripture. Do you know, it may be a weird piece of scripture, but it is one of my most favourite. They are the words of someone who knows himself completely, has a real understanding of his follies and frailties. And yet he has the certainty that he's within touch of being the person he was created to be. It had not been an easy journey for him. He'd not always made the right choices. He'd not always fought the right battles. And from what we know, he had not been an easy person to be near. But his trust in God helped him through his struggles and kept him moving forward. At the heart of his faith is the sheer wonder of having been chosen by God, redeemed by Christ, and strengthened by the Holy Spirit. And so let us pray the prayer for today. Faithful Lord, whose steadfast love never ceases and whose mercies never come to an end, grant us the grace to trust you, to receive the gifts of your love, new every morning, in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. About 30 years ago, I heard this version of a famous hymn. I listened because it was to a different tune. And because I listened carefully, for me, the world stopped and my life changed. I'm going to play that version of that hymn to you now. Hope the day goes well for you. Look forward to seeing you again. God bless.
And can it be that I should gain an interest in my Saviour's blood? Died he for me who caused his pain, for me who scorned his perfect love? Amazing love, how can it be that you, my God, would die for me? Boldly I come.